Welcome to number two in the building the bridge from scratch using 360 Cricut machine. I'll probably throw in a bit of 3D printing as well. But so in Fusion, I nearly made the fatal mistake by not making this a component. It's now a body inside the main document. So rectify that. I'll click on the body, right click it, and go to create component from body. And this way, name that area. What I've also done, I've raised it up 6 millimeters so I can use the edges to build off the faces. We'll start off with a new component, we'll call it Year One. Rectangles to shape to start off with. So I'll finish the sketch there. I'm going to extrude this face backwards. This is just a basic start off shape. Folks today will need to do quite a bit of stuff to it. We'll go minus 30. Now we can build off this face here. That's the first pier done now. It's a bit sharp here, the edges there. I've got an option here. I can make it with card, I can make it with 3D print, I can make it resin or filament. I have decided to make it a 3D print. That's better. Zoom in a whole touch. My head area again, a simple box up. Same again, I'll get a 3mm chamfer on the corners as well. A square. That corner there, that corner there. Bring it down 40mm. Let's put it in. It goes in 15mm. Orientation. For some reason, I've not cut that part. The easy way to do that is just to do a wee sketch on top of it and slice it. Let's do that down to this here. Better. Well, folks, that's a two piers done. I've got to see them. Pier number one, pier number two. I have to be honest with you, I did make a mistake in the first prints. tried to hollow out the walls, and it took over 12 hours to print. So rather than doing that, I cut the print down, made the walls thin, and suffered the consequences. Also, I had to cut a bit off this part here as it was filling. We went to the train. So to export them, you right click, which is say save as mesh. Save as mesh. Okay that. Save. Number two. Save as mesh. And okay as well. Save. So we'll nip over to Cura now. And you can, I'll show you how I sliced them. You probably hear a printer going in the background there, is doing the prints. So, in here, you can only take one at a time. You can't take two. If you're trying to do two, I tell a lie. Too close together to get a tobacco touch. Now, in the settings, I've got low quality settings there. And what I did, I went down the speed. I changed the speed from 50 to 60. And we'll see how I slice it, perhaps. A 5.5 hour print. Need to take the pain, So I'm going to print it off there. Once I print it off, I'll show you on the layout. It's now printing off. You can see here, folks, I'm using the lighting supports for no support info for the print there. And I'm just starting to put the lighting effect here as well. The walls are, well, there we have it, folks. The finished prints looking very nice. Came in at 5 hours 20. There's a little line here. Don't know if you can see it. You can see it as well. That's probably something to do with the printer setup. Well, that's the in situ, folks. Turned out real nice. Just ready for the bridge deck to go on top yet. I will paint them up over the weekend. Come up towards that time, hug my knee. So, the first two prints, just a total disaster. sometimes you're better taking the pain and going for the quality rather than the time-wise and life as it is. I'll take a look to see it, edge it. Now, before it was clear the train, now it is clearing the train. No problems whatsoever. Once it all set in hot touch, of course. Now, system, no problem. So I'm really, really pleased with it. I will be putting a coat in here. This one is going to be half brick, half stone, and the top half is concrete. And I'll just let you see the picture from West Calder again to let you see it. The bridge deck sits on top of it. So, wish you all the best, folks. I'll get this video out before the end of the year. And I wish you all the best for 2023.